Okay, in today's lecture in HVDC N5, we'll discuss about the reactive power requirement and the harmonic generation in HVDC system. The contents of today's topic will be reactive power requirement and harmonic generation. So, reactive power requirement. HVDC converter absorb reactive power approximately 50% to 60% of their active power. Harmonic filters are installed on AC side for the filtering the AC current and for generation of reactive power. So I'm just drawing one schematic diagram of HVDC link here, so it will be convenient for you to understand. So this is the generating end or sending end, and it is receiving end. This type of transformer or converter transformer at sending end, converter transformer at receiving end. This is converter station 1, converter station 1, and here it is converter station 2. This is the transmission line. HVDC link, which is consist of converter 1, converter 2. It converts AC into DC and it converts DC into AC. This is the sending end, this is receiving end. These are the converter transformers. So as in the first point, the converters, HVDC converters absorb reactive power at approximately 50 to 60% of their active power. The harmonic filters are installed. The harmonic filters will install here on the AC side for filtering the AC current and for generation of reactive power here and also here. The reactive power absorb of a converter increases with the transmitted active power. So as the active power increases, the reactive power absorption will also increase. And also the need for filtering of harmonic is increased. So as the active power increases, the harmonics will also increase, and at the same time the reactive power absorption will also increase. The need for reactive power grows slowly at low power and more pronounced at high power, whereas the filter needs behave in the opposite fashion. So it is very well clear, as the active power grows slowly at low power and more pronounced at high power, so the filter requirement will be opposite. The reactive power compensation scheme has to take care of the unbalances for the AC system requirement by switching off filters. So in this point we'll discuss that reactive power compensation scheme. The scheme which is incorporated in the circuit or used in the HVDC system or a power system, that reactive power compensation has to take care for the unbalances of AC system requirement. So if as the system unbalances and the load on the various phases or the three phases will change, so by switching of the filters will manage the reactive power requirement of the system. Here the graph shows the current ID, current flowing through the transmission line, and the reactive power. So this is the case of converter, this is the case for inverter. The blue line shows that as the current increases, the filter requirement is also increases. purpose of reactive power control? What is the purpose? Why reactive power requirement is needed in HVDC system or power system? The purpose of reactive power control is to control the properties of AC network that are connected to the converter station. The reactive power control will also make sure that the required filter are connected to prevent excessive harmonics. Prevent the excessive harmonics that may enter into AC system. So the reactive power controller will work. Will give two types of working. First, it will control the reactive power requirement, and also the filters which are used are manage the system such that excessive harmonics will not enter into the AC system. How the harmonics is generated in the system or in HVDC? Because of the presence of converter station. Here for converting AC into DC and here for converting DC into AC, the switching devices are used, the power semiconductor switching devices like SCR, MOSFET, GTO. So by switching of these devices, the harmonics will generate and that harmonics will enter into the AC side. Here it is AC, same as here. The harmonics will not enter into the AC system when here installed the filters. Okay. Installed the filters. So these harmonics will grounded with the help of these filters, and this filter also used for compensating the reactive power requirement. The tasks are performed by switching of filter banks. So the task for reducing or eliminating the harmonics as well as the reactive power component is being performed by switching of the filter bank or switching of the capacitor bank which are connected to the system. Now, reactive power control. The reactive power balance of each side of HVDC transmission will normally be performed by reactive power controller, and each controller is located at the pole control level and operates independently from the reactive power controller in the other end of the HVDC transmission line. So the reactive power controller will be installed at the pole end and they are working independently with each other. The switching of filter banks or sub banks is ordered by the RPC, that is reactive power controller, or by protection. So here one more thing is there, that is protection. The switching of filter banks, capacitor bank, is ordered by either by the reactive power controller or by the protection system. So for the reactive power control, when reactive power controller will send signal to the switching controller of the filter bank when the reactive power compensation is being required, and for protection purpose, if there will be any malfunction will appear occur at that time, the protection system will also order the filter banks. The switching property restrictions are determined by limits in the reactive power compensation study for the different control mode. So which type of switching required or how the controller is being designed for switching these filter banks or capacitor banks, is being determined by the reactive power compensation limit. How much reactive power is being compensated for a particular type of transmission line. Now, selection of AC filter configuration due to reactive power requirements. The AC filters, PLC filters and surge capacitor banks generate reactive power to compensate the reactive power compensation by the converter. So these are the filters, AC filter, PLC filter, surge capacitor are used to compensate the reactive power requirement or reactive power requirement generated by the converter, converter station 1 and converter station 2. The compensation of reactive power varies linearly with the active power, but the generation can only be changed in step by switching in or out of filter banks. Therefore, there will be a net interchange of reactive power with the network. So, it is clearly understandable that the consumption of reactive power varies linearly with the active power. As the active power changes, the reactive power will also change, but the generation can only be changed in steps of switching in and out of the generation, which is talking about the reactive power generation. The demand will not be in the hand of the designer. The load demand will change. As the load demand changes, the reactive power will change. And to compensate that reactive power, we have to in and out, in or out the capacitor banks or filter banks to the system. But these filter banks will not in and out gradually. It will be changed in steps, say 1, 2 or like this. Therefore, there will be a net interchange of reactive power with the network. This maximum size of filter bank may also be influenced by the permitted voltage step size at the switching of the bank. This is one more point, that how much capacitor or shunt capacitor or filters we can incorporate in the system are connected to the transmission line. It will depend upon the what will be the permitted voltage step size. So the calculation will be done in such that we should have know about what will be the permitted step size. So by inserting the capacitor bank or filter into the system, the reactive power will absorb or reactive power will be compensated, so the voltage will change, the system voltage will change, which will be with respect to the permitted voltage step size. So you see in this particular characteristic, that is reactive power for typical AC filter switching sequence. This is the power in per unit, active power per unit, reactive power per unit. So, as you have seen, by inserting the capacitor bank or filter, the change in the change will be like this. Here it will be the step size. So the capacitor or filters will be in and out in steps, but the power will grow gradually. This is the schematic diagram of a converter station. So these are the main components of converter station, that is AC bus, shunt filters or other reactive equipment, AC filters, then converter station, this is the converter transformer, then this is the converter which converts AC into DC. Here in this case it will convert AC into DC. This is the control mechanism, which is control system, which sends signal to the rectifier block or converter block, so that the switching of SCR will be done in such a way that it will convert AC into the required DC. This is the smoothing reactor, which is used to eliminate the ripples at the DC side. This is DC filter, which will be used, or the use of DC filter is to convert the or eliminate the ripples into the DC system, and at this particular transmission side will get exact DC waveform. Here after rectification, our converter will get this type of DC. So with the help of smoothing reactor and DC filter, we'll get the exact DC output waveform. This control mechanism is also having the port which communicate with the receiving end with the help of telecommunication channels, and nowadays it will be communicated with the microwave communication. So this is the converter station, which is at the sending end. Same as there will be another converter station which will convert DC into AC. So both the converter station will communicate with the help of the communication channel. And this will be a monopolar HVDC link, because it is having a single conductor. Usually the conductor is having the negative polarity. Why we have to take the negative polarity of that single conductor? So that the radio interference losses will be less. Now the harmonic generation. How the harmonics is being generated in HVDC system? So these are the characteristics of idealized converter. The supply voltage is exactly symmetrical. The supply AC voltage is exactly symmetrical. This is the important characteristics of an ideal converter. Second, the direct current is perfectly constant without ripples. So in this particular case, we are talking about the inverter. The output of inverter should be exactly same as AC sinusoidal waveform. And in case of converter or rectifier, the direct current is perfectly constant without ripples, like this. And here it will be like this, not in steps. So for that, infinite smoothing reactor is being required. The firing angles of each phases are perfectly equal. Also, the commutation impedances are equal in three phases. For the ideal working, this two point must be there in the converter operation. The firing angle of each phases are perfectly equal, so that the output will be exactly symmetrical as the AC voltage, and the commutation impedances are equal in three phases. So this is once again we'll talk about the converter station, how the harmonics is being generated. So you see here AC bus, converter transformer, this is star 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 delta, converter station. Here the AC sinusoidal wave is given to the converter station, then the output will be DC in nature. Or vice versa, if we consider from this side, so DC will be given to the inverter station and the AC signal will be exactly symmetrical to the AC waveform in case of ideal converter. So in this figure, in this diagram, you see here this is the case for current I1. This is I1 is the fundamental component. I1 is the fundamental component. Fundamental component of the signal. I2 is the second harmonic. So, as the switching occurs, what switching is important or necessary to convert for the conversion of AC into DC or DC into AC with the help of converter station. So switching is necessary. Now by that switching the harmonics will generate. So here we will take the fundamental component. This is the second harmonic. So by combining this we will get I1 plus I2. In case of switching or converter station, there will be n number of harmonic is being generated. See here, this is the first fifth harmonic, seventh harmonic, 11th harmonic, 13, 19, 25th and n number. So as the order of harmonics is increases, the amplitude or magnitude will decrease. But as the harmonics are nearer to the fundamental value, fundamental signal, the magnitude will be higher. This will represent here. This is for the phase current. Same as here, I1 fundamental component, second harmonic, and this will be the I1 plus I2. Now the harmonics, then the convert characteristics harmonic current on AC side of converter station. So we'll take a star star 6 pulse converter. Star star 6 pulse converter as drawn here. The star delta, the transformer will be star connected and the output will send to the 6 pulse converter. Star star 3 phase converter transformer connect, and the output is connected to a 6 pulse converter. So the I1 will be given as 2 into root 3 by pi id cos omega t minus 1 by pi cos pi omega t plus 1 by 7 cos 7 omega t minus 1 by 11 cos 11 omega t and so on. Where id is the direct current and I1 is the fundamental current, which will be given by 2 into root 6 by pi id, and the nth harmonic will be shown like this, where n is equal to 11, 13, 23 and so on. So this is the characteristics harmonic current on AC side of converter. Where the number of harmonics n is equal to 12k plus minus 1, where k is 1, 2, 3. So by putting the value of k 1, we'll get 11, 13, 2, 23 and 25, 3, 35, 46 and so on. So In is the harmonic current, kn is the reduction factor due to overlap, and I1 is the fundamental AC current. So by this way we'll get an information that with the help by switching, how much harmonic or the number of harmonic present are generated in our system. So this is the characteristics of AC harmonic current. This is the direct current and the amplitude converter AC harmonic current as a function of direct current, that is around 1500 ampere. So as you see here, this is the characteristics of 11th harmonic. Here you see this is 13th harmonic. This will be the red one, will be 23rd harmonic. This one will be 25th harmonic. So as the number of harmonic, the order of harmonic increases, the amplitude will go down. So 11th harmonic will have the higher amplitude as compared to the 35th harmonic. Since the inductive reactance of converter transformer gives a gradual transfer of current from one phase to another and so rounds the steps of current waveform. So what will be this inductive reactance of converter transformer? We'll talk about the source inductance. So the transformer will have the inductive reactance. So by this inductive reactance, the gradual transfer of current from one phase to another, which I show you here. This is a 6 pulse transformer. Here we get the DC. Say this is T1, T3, T5, T4, T6, T2. So from the switching combination, let's say the current from T1 will shift to the T3. So this is the current flowing from T1, as the T1 is in conduction state and T3 is will be turn off state or forward blocking mode. Now as the transition takes place, the current from T1 will go through T3. So when there will, in ideal condition, what will assume that, or what will take that, the current from this T1, that is I1, is suddenly comes to zero, and the T3, the current from T3, thyristor 3, will increase instantly to the rated value. So from this instant, this will be I3, this will be I1. This is an ideal. But as we know that the inductive reactances are source impedances are present there in the circuit. So in case of, in practical case, what will happen? What will happen? The current from this SCR T1 will gradually decrease. And this will gradually increase. So this is now I3, this is I1, and this period is known as overlapping period. So the inductive reactance of converter transformer gives a gradual transform of current from one phase to another, and so around the step of current waveform. The characteristics harmonic will decrease with increased commutation reactor. So if we increase the commutation reactor, the harmonics will be lower. So this is what I drawn in previous slide, that the current pulses with overlap. So here this overlap angle is shown with the help of U. A 6 pulse converter where the overlap angle is greater than 0. So these are the overlap angles. So imperfection of converter. Why the harmonics is generated? Because of the imperfection of the converter, the odd 6 pulse harmonic that are supposed to cancel perfectly in 12 pulse converter may not do so because of some small differences in reactance or in turn ratio between the star star and star delta connected transformer. So this is because of the small difference in the reactance, this will not happen. The second one, there is always some difference in transformer reactance of each phase due to manufacturing tolerance. So will not get the exact similar reactance on each phase. So by this also will get harmonic. The phase voltage are not exactly similar. For example, contain a small negative sequence component, and there may be a spread in firing angle for the different valves or different SCR due to imperfection in control system. So due to imperfection in control system means there will be slight imperfection in the firing mechanism. So non-characteristics harmonics. So imperfection AC side and DC side. So in AC side, the negative sequence that is third, fifth and seventh distortion will get fifth and seventh harmonic, and DC side will get sixth harmonic. Due to transformer reactance, the difference between reactance in star star and star delta will get fifth and seventh harmonic. There will get sixth harmonic. So difference between the phases in AC side will get odd harmonic, in DC side will get even harmonic, and firing asymmetry is because of the differences in the firing circuit or malfunctioning in the firing circuit will get the harmonic, AC harmonic, AC side harmonics, and also DC side harmonics. So the converter AC harmonic current as a function of direct current. So here the 5th, 7th, 9th and 15th harmonics are shown. This is the direct current and amplitude. the imperfect, that is the same thing. The magnitude of non-characteristic harmonic is small to the characteristic harmonic. The magnitude of non-characteristic harmonic is small as to the characteristic harmonic. The most of have a minor influence on the total harmonic distortion with n filter design. So, in case of non-characteristic harmonics on AC side, the influence will be minor on total harmonic distortion, PHD and filter design. However, if the short circuit impedance on AC network is high, it could result a high distortion of the lower order non-characteristic harmonic on AC bus voltage due to parallel resonance between the network and filter banks. So these are the, this is the important point in case of non-characteristic harmonic. So characteristic harmonics on DC side for 12 pulse converter, that is n is equal to 12k, where k is 1, 2, 3 and so on. So by this way, by putting k is equal to 1, we'll get 12, by putting k is equal to 2, 24 and so on. This is the characteristic harmonic voltage across a converter as a function of overlap angle at firing angle of 15 degree. So the alpha will take as 15 degree and the overlap angle is present there. So here this is the overlap angle in degree. This is voltage in PU for ideal. So 12 harmonics, 24 harmonics, 36 harmonics and 48 harmonics are shown here. The characteristic harmonics voltage across the converter as a function, in previous slides we will see this. As the overlap increases from a very low value at a minimum current to a value in range 15 to 25 at nominal current, it can be seen that for the 12th harmonic that the harmonic generation is high at low load operation, then decreases to a minimum before rising again to a value eventually greater than that at low load operation. For higher order harmonics, the maximum generation does not occur at full load. There are several local maxima progressive increasing in peak amplitude within the feasible range of overlap angle. So, this is how the harmonics is generated in the HVDC system, and the reactive power compensation is being taken care in HVDC transmission line.